rush to start a dental practice because you don't want to waste a year. 1 year is you give yourself.
So we all hear that dentistry is very saturated today. How can we create a brand name in this overly competitive environment? And what are the equipments that you must invest on when you start off fresh?
So first thing, it is not saturated. Most of these dentists are actually practicing in the city, the urban areas, the tier 1 and tier 2 cities. And in rural areas, there is one dentist to like 50,000-60,000 people.
Yeah.
So we are not saturated. Even the urban population is now increasing. So there's everything, there's something for everybody. So that is first thing that you need to understand. When you start a dental practice, don't start investing in everything and anything. Like, somebody told me this, I should buy. No. First, you invest in learning. Okay, you invest your money in learning newer, newer skills. And even in those courses, don't blindly believe everything that has been said to you in this course. Arey, nahi, ek, one course on root canal is saying that there should be a periapical bulge for the good seal. And one other course says that 0.5 mm short rakho. No? See what works in your case. There are cases wherein, doctors have believed that the bulge is very important and pushed the material so much out that, the patient has started getting swelling and then the whole appendectomy and all that has to be done. So don't get yourselves into those kind of situations. Practice what you feel is correct for that patient. That is one thing. Secondly, overly competitive, it is good because then the world knows about dentistry. The people are more aware, they are more educated. So the chances of you getting everything that has been done in a neighboring clinic to your clinic is very, very high. Then coming to the materials that you need to invest in is a good dental chair. A very, very good X-ray, that is something that you should buy, like a digital X-ray. Don't go into that. अरे मेरे पास पैसा आएगा तो डिजिटल खरीदूंगा. डिजिटल एक्सरे इज समथिंग दैट यू शुड इन्वेस्ट इन. यू कैन नॉट इन्वेस्ट इन द अदर थिंग्स, लाइक बाकी सब चीज़ों पे मत करो कि अगर फिजियो है सो यू वांट टू प्रैक्टिस इन इम्प्लांट इंडस्ट्री, यू डिड इम्प्लांट कोर्स एंड यू बॉट अ फिजियो, यू नो दैट यू गोइंग टू इंक्रीज द प्रैक्टिस, यू बाय दैट. व्हेन यू बाय इट, यू स्टार्ट अल्टीमेटली स्टार्ट गिविंग दैट थिंग्स. तो मेरे साथ तो ऐसा हुआ है कि आई हैड माय like when I bought a laser, first thought was, अरे laser क्यों खरीद लिया, it was so expensive. Then now it's so much of use and it doesn't affect us, And then coming to the point that, when we think about say physio, today, as of today, I in Ortho Square have 12 physios. It's actually good that you invest in that material that is going to be used in your practice. So understand, analyze and invest into your practice that way.
Right.
That is the first thing. And secondly, don't be in a rush to start a dental practice because you don't want to waste a year. 1 year is you give yourself, understand what you like, what you don't like, what are the materials that you will need, because clinical dentistry is very, very different
from
what you do in college. So that way.
So apart from that, you've been working at Nanavati Hospital. So my question is that what is the difference, even from the patient point of view and even from you as a practicing clinician, when you're working at Nanavati Hospitals and when you're working at a clinic?
The first and the most important skill that a practicing dentist at a hospital like Nanavati should have is their diagnostic skills. Because you get cases which are out of this world, like you will not see them in your clinical practice ever. So because you see these kind of cases which have a lot of systemic issues, so your knowledge of your general body has to be great. Medicine, science, you should know your pharma in and out. What happens with Ecosprints, or what happens with XYZ medicine a doctor patient is taking. We had a lot of patients pre-surgery, सो दोज आर द काइंड ऑफ केसेज दैट वी डू अ लॉट एंड लॉट यू नो इन आवर प्रैक्टिस. तो वो सब चीज़ों को वी विल हैव टू अपग्रेड एंड अपग्रेड एंड अपग्रेड. सो दैट इज़ वन मेजर डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ जनरल प्रैक्टिस एंड अ हॉस्पिटल प्रैक्टिस. सो यू नीड दो स्किल्स टू डायग्नोज. सेकेंडली the hospitals are have a very high level of you know, they program wherein, you know, they have that feedback program.
Yeah.
So that makes a practice really, really tough because you need to make sure that your game is a game with every patient. So that is something like there will be not even one patient who will come in your clinic and say ki mujhe refund de do.
Yeah.
It will never happen. It will, like, it will not happen.
Yeah.
But when you go to hospital setups, patients feel that, you know, like hospital owns them and everything. So वो एक थोड़ा सा difference हो जाता है. But the only advantage in a hospital setup is you get ready-made patients.
Okay.
Yeah, because the hospital has their own OPD, so you start getting that OPD. So that's how it works.
So does a patient prefer coming to the hospital, like when you tell them that, you know, tomorrow you need to come to Nanavati, or like tomorrow you need to come to the clinical setup?
Patient wants to come to the closest center.
Okay, so it doesn't matter if it is a hospital.
If you are a doctor, a good doctor, they reviewed you, they know you, they will come for you anywhere. But if you are a doctor who can be available at near to their place, they will prefer that. That is the first preference. But yes, they now in COVID time, they don't like to come to hospital.
Yeah.
So, but otherwise, Nanavati, yeah. It makes a lot of difference.